Hello my friends, this is Mikhail, and today I'm going to show you how to make your own microphone for your YouTube projects. Wait, hold on. Mom, I told you that I'm making my YouTube video, hold on. Okay, let's roll.
First of all, we will need to gather some parts. Unfortunately for me, I'm a hoarder. So, I took this bag of some stuff. Also, this is, I think, a FM transmitter I made some few years ago, but it has a microphone. And lastly, a high quality audio cable from some old Soviet amplifier. Okay, so let's take a look what we actually have here. This is a simple FM transmitter that I built for no particular reason. It has some decent wire on it. But the most important thing, it has a microphone that we are going to use today. Next, we have a bag of various loose parts, and the part we are looking for is 3.5mm audio connector. I want this kind of connector because my computer has a port for it. So here we have one part of this connector, and here is the other part. So now we have a whole connector. Now let's clear up a little. Oh boy, I sure do have a lot of stuff hoarded. This is a high quality shielded cable, but you could use any microphone cable. Now let's clean it up a little bit and prepare it for soldering to the microphone by twisting wires. Now let's use the famous glazomera to determine how long wires should be. Oh boy, these tiny bastards need some trimming. Let's trim them. But you know what? I want a microphone that would stand up straight, so I got an idea. We will use a piece of wire to reinforce the cable. Here you can see the consequences of hoarding. A poor Eastern European dude struggles to unwind wire from the spool and straighten it. But overall, it's going well. So now, let's try desoldering the microphone. And yes, it is extremely important to clean your soldering iron before you do any work. Okay, so one wire here, another one here, and bam! We have our microphone unit. So now, let's take our cable, tin the ends of it, and solder to our microphone. Tinning loose ends of our cable is extremely important. Well, okay, not important, but helpful for prevention of splitting. Because then, it would be hard to keep them tight and tidy. Okay, now keeping in mind that microphone itself is a very fragile component, maybe sticking the reinforcement cable before soldering a microphone on would be a better idea. Furthermore, I just found that my reinforcement wire is too thick to fit into my microphone cable, so I will try to fit it in without the insulation. Unfortunately, you can't see my face when I'm trying to stick this thing in, because it was fine at first, but later on, it was becoming increasingly difficult. Yet another example of struggling Eastern European. But finally, I thought to try using pliers to fit this thing in, and, well, it worked wonders. So now we will have to put on 3.5mm connector somehow. It doesn't want to fit at first, so we might use our pliers to get it a little bit thinner. And here comes my trusty third hand in to help. We will fit one side of the connector into it and solder the wires of a microphone cable. That dark brown paste that you can see on the corner of screen is actually flux. And you need to use a flux, not a lot, but just a little bit, to make solder joints a little bit stronger, smoother, and generally nicer. So I apply a little bit more flux and wires and soldering it. Oh well, it's a little bit hot, but whatever. I can hold it and so can you. Okay, so now let's try to put the connector together. It don't want to fit at first, but little fiddling, the pliers will do the job just fine. So we have our microphone ready, well, almost ready. We need to secure ends of reinforcement cable to connect. But, well, I made a mistake. You need a longer reinforcement cable than your microphone cable. because otherwise you will have a lot of trouble fixing it to your connector. But in Eastern Europe, there is no situation that couldn't be fixed. So I soldered a longer piece of reinforcement wire, and now we will be just fine. Now, let's try to fix that reinforcement wire to our connector. I chose to do that by just simply rolling it over. Oh, you can see here me rolling it over the microphone itself. Isn't it a beauty? Now, let's wrap it over the connector itself. One wrap, two wraps, three wraps. Okay, that should be enough. Let's trim the end so we wouldn't impale ourselves or anybody else. And we have our microphone. Let's clean up table a little bit and go to test our newly made microphone.
Okay, so now I'm recording with my phone microphone. But check out this beauty that we have made. Isn't it beautiful? Well, it certainly looks cool. Okay, but how does it record? Well, we'll check this just right now. Let's plug it in into this laptop. Okay, it's standing well like an antenna. Very cool, don't you think? Okay, now let's try recording some audio with it on Audacity. Okay, there is some noise on this microphone, but I suspect that it's just because of poor connector, you know? Because when I fold it like this, there is much less noise. Okay, so now let's hear how it sounds on the computer. Wait, what is this? Integrated microphone array? Oh, that bastard! So this computer had microphones all along. Okay, so let's try comparing with these microphones. Microphone that I made and microphone that is installed on this computer already. So now I will record on my computer. Hello guys, how are you? And now I will record on my microphone. Hello guys, how are you? Okay, let's hear from the computer how it sounds. How it really sounds.
Hello guys, how are you? Hello guys, how are you? Obviously, the levels of microphones are mismatched. So to have a better comparison, let's normalize them. Hello guys, how are you? Hello guys, how are you? The integrated microphone sounds a little bit duller, but we both have a lot of noise and are not the best microphones. So let's try to remove noise by using the same Audacity software. Hello guys, how are you? Hello guys, how are you? So the conclusion, microphones, both the integrated into the laptop and made by my hands, are, well, kinda poor quality. One of the things that you could do to improve quality of your homemade microphone would be to use a higher quality microphone unit itself. For example, try to take it from a broken device like phone or studio microphone, or some similar device. Well, you know, the stuff that usually is of higher quality. As for my project, I used the stuff that I found laying around. And in my case, the microphone unit was the one that I bought from AliExpress about 3 years ago for, I don't remember, but about $1 for 10 of them. So, the moral of the story would be, you get what you paid for.
So that's all for this video today. If you would like me to show you how to make something Eastern European style, then comment below. And for now, like, share, subscribe, and keep on cheeky breaking, my friends.